Hello YouTube, this is Genuine Greatness and welcome back to episode 2 of our Let's Play Agrarian Skies 2. Last time we got started on this miserable little skyblock and we did get 19% of learning to skyblock completed. Off camera I said I was going to, I don't know what I said I was going to do, even though I recorded the last session literally like 20 minutes ago. Anyways, off camera, it rained. I'm literally recording probably a minute and 30 seconds after it stopped raining. It's been raining for so long now. And there were so many mobs that... Look at all this loot that I got. That's just amazing how much loot I was able to get. So I even got an enderpearl, which is amazing. Enderpearls are amazing. And while there were no mobs outside, I did decide to put a silkworm on the tree so that I could make myself a bed for future. I also did decide to repair my hatchet because it had actually run out from killing all these mobs. And but first I would like to combine these two bows in an effort of organization and also usability. Right. Okay. I would like to take this crook out now and just start going away at this. Getting some silkworms and some string in the process. I do need 12 pieces of string for a bed. And I do believe I already have 6 pieces, so I only need 6 pieces of string, really, to even get started on anything. And we're gonna have plenty of string once we start our mob farm, so not to worry. Aw, that's incomplete. Whatever. Oh, I love the speed on this thing. It's so awesome. Okay. So, we did do our daily dosage of farming. So, 12 pieces of string equates us... 3 pieces of wool. This combined with 3 pieces of oakwood planks gets us a bed. Yes. I'm just going to put that right there. So now we can sleep and set our home, even though home is already set. And I don't know what he's doing, but whatever. We can leave him be. Okay, so last time we left off in the quest book, we had all these quests that we could complete. Ooh, that's not good. Anyways, so last time you guys remember we used our clay to make ourselves a clay bucket. Now I realize that in order to complete this quest, we need a clay bucket. Hooray! Oh, that's gonna be a pain. Okay, whatever. So, in order to get clay... Yeah, in order to do any of these quests, I need to actually be able to use my bucket. And the only way I'm going to be able to use my bucket is if I make a furnace. So, I'm going to cut camera, guys, and when I'm back, I will have a full-fledged furnace ready to go. I'll be back in a sec, guys. We're back, guys. So, off camera, I did get myself 6 pieces of cobblestone. Now, you guys may be wondering... Genuine. Isn't a furnace 8 pieces of cobblestone? Well, thanks to Tinker's Construct, there is an item called the Slab Furnace. Yes. So, yeah, this item is pretty much just saved my life. Slap the slab furnace down and it's basically a furnace. And I believe there's a quest with unclaimed... Here we go. Apparently, there is an item. Or there was a quest that says hunting monsters and I need to kill 10 creepers. I will select this reward bag. We just got a spawn blizz, which will actually get us blizz powder. So, I don't know if I'm going to implement that into a spawn room or not. But this is a good reward bag and it got us another umbral rose. Oh man, I just love getting umbral roses. It's amazing. That was a sarcastic comment, by the way. Sheep slaughter. Yikes. Don't want to do that. Kill the boss. Yeah. Oh, an emerald. Nice. Anyways. There's no... Oh, look at all these things that have suddenly... Alright, well, I just want to complete this quest line. So, we need clay. But before anything, we need... Actually, where is it? We need a bucket, basically. I forgot what we needed it for, but we do need a bucket. And actually, before that, we do need torches. So what I want to do is I want to cook up 8 pieces of charcoal. And the first piece of charcoal will actually be used to cook up the rest. So, just put 9 there. Okay. And that is solving that. But actually, I'm going to get a bit impatient right now, so I'm going to take out my unfired clay bucket. And do this. And also, off camera, I did do a bit of terraforming. As you guys can see, I did lower this platform a little bit and added the 4 pieces of dirt. I also added 4 pieces of dirt to this area so that we could start farming. Because I would love to start a farm. That is really annoying me. And also off camera, I did get to level up my writing pick, and I did get +1 reinforced. Which basically means I think it takes less damage. I'm not sure. Don't quote me on that, though. And, so what I'd like to do is I'd like to get started actually cooking this, stuff up. Okay, now that we have a fired clay bucket. The thing that you can do with a fired clay bucket is you can move water. That's pretty much it. If you try to move anything else but water with the... Actually, if you try to move lava with the clay bucket, your bucket's gonna break. And we don't want that. So... I want the water right here. Ooh, that's not good. Oh, come on. I can't really see. Alright, sweet. Take this water. Bang. And now we have an unlimited water source, which is excellent. Because now I can go sleep in my bed and be safe from monsters. Come on, bed. Thank you. So we are getting a lot of progress done, guys. Okay. Before any mobs really got the chance to spawn, I went to bed. Okay. Anyways, there was a quest that we needed to do. Wasn't this one? Yes, here we go. We need clay. And to get clay, we need to put dust in a barrel of water. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to take from our infinite water source, put a bucket in there, and bam. Now we have a piece of clay. Now we either get bones or porcelain clay. I'm going to take the porcelain clay, simply because the porcelain clay is actually useful for something else later on, which is I'm about to make right now, actually. And we have plenty of bones due to the fact that there are so many monsters spawning. It's kind of unreal. Anyways, ooh, look at this. Alternative containers. So we have completed this quest, as you guys can see. And the clay bucket is used for early game moving items and stuff. Okay. So here we unlock molten stone. To get lava, you will need to melt stone. To melt stone, you will need to heat a crucible. You will need a crucible placed over a heat source. Currently, your best heat source is a torch. Okay, so I need 7 porcelain clay. Porcelain clay is just... Since I can't hand this in, porcelain clay is just... bone meal and clay. Why did I do that? I'm stupid. Since this is a crafting task, I'm afraid I cannot submit it. The crucible, and now I need to make a crucible. I may as well make 2. I mean, There's a precious doll. But porcelain clay is easy to get. And unfired crucibles are currently a priority. Okay. I'm going to put this in here. I do want to make a couple of torches. So... base 32 torches. Now if we press F7, we can see which areas need lighting up so that no monsters will spawn. Okay. Just go around the back. Placing torches. This little area. And this little area right here. Okay. I also need to fill up that hole because that's giving me like a nervous... that's making me a nervous wreck right now is that little hole. And the fact that I'm starving is also making me just a bit nervous. So... that doesn't look good, does it? So stupid. Why so many micro parts? They look fancy and all, but I mean... is this really necessary? And I really don't want to fall into the void right now. That'd be terrible if I fell into the void. That means I'd lose everything I have right now. To be quite fair. Okay. Now I'm just gonna place these blocks right down. So there's no way I can fall into the void right now. And, as an additional bonus, I do believe I can just put these down. Okay, perfect. Now it looks good as new. So, what I want to do now is I want to get a good source of food because currently I'm starving. Which is not good. But, before I do that, we did get a watering can from a previous quest reward. Now that we have filled it up, we can water stuff. Hooray! Okay, anyways. Now we need to make a hoe. So, a couple of wood planks should do. And, by the way guys, Iguana Tweaks makes it so that you cannot use vanilla tools. However, God dang it. Can I make a hoe? Can I make a hoe? Hoe, okay. That is depressing. What does it say about freaking these agricraft? I should have gotten the hoe. God dang it. Okay. We can easily fix this. And we just need food. I wonder if you can eat creeper heads. You cannot eat creeper heads. No! I'm about to die. Holy crap. I don't have any more food. Oh good, I have monster jerky. Monster jerky will not help me for very long though, so... I do believe I want 2 flint pieces. Also want a shovel. You want a handle. Okay. Getting kind of frazzled here due to the fact that I barely have any time to make all this. Flint axe, flint shovel, perfect. And I can just use a stick. So now I'm just going to do this and I'll be right back. We're back guys, so I apparently died off camera. I forgot to log off when I was going to do something, and I guess, is it right there? Yeah, I don't know what happened, guys. I'm sorry to tell you guys. I think I lost my frying pan. It's kind of unfortunate that I lost my frying pan, but, it's fine. So, ooh, I got myself a Flintmatic. I'm gonna call this first... I'm actually gonna call this Matic. First Matic. Bam. Now we can, I believe we can till. Yes. We can finally till the dirt. And we will get modifiers for it. Anyways, I would like to, again, delete this embarrassing waypoint. And I believe we are only down to 4 lives now. Yeah, ouch. Okay. I apparently left my... Yeah, I apparently left my door open or something. I don't even know what happened. I really hope I didn't lose anything crucial. Alright, I did get my crucibles, though. I'm very happy about that, actually. I'm gonna place my crucibles. These stupid covers. Or these stupid panels. I can't even remove the panels. That's a pain. Kinda running out of room, actually, to do everything. I'm just gonna put these right here. And then I'm gonna dig underneath and put torches under them. Now they are an adequate source of heat. I'm gonna put everything in here. Okay, right. Onto the quest book. We need more stone. Oh, wow. Okay. What happened to all of my freaking torches? Literally, all of my torches, I just disappeared. What happened? Was there like a zombie invasion or something? Like, what happened to all the torches I just placed? That's so stupid. Anyways, can't stay on that sorry note. What was I gonna do? Oh yeah, I was going to start Agricraft. Since, alright, well, how you do Agricraft is put your crops like this, take your seeds, I'm gonna use this, this, and this, potato seeds, and I'm not going to start Agricraft just yet. I'm not going to start the complicated research process. I just want to quickly get some food. I love this watering can. Anyways, that basically solved our food problem. We do still have some problems, however. One, we need to have cobble gen. Oh, I'm supposed to manually detect this one. Okay, so we can actually complete this quest and... We need, I believe it's 4 or 5 pieces of cobblestone just to be able to do this quiz, this quest. Dang it, I keep saying quiz. As you can see, my crops have matured. So, I'm gonna get like 32 saplings off camera, because that's, I believe that's the amount of them I need to get. 32 saplings. Oh boy. Okay. Yeah. I will be back when I have grown and harvested 32 saplings. And we're back, guys. So, I did get 39 saplings, and I have been trying to cut down this tree for the past, like, 10 minutes now. It's kind of ridiculous how hard I'm... Oh, that's not good. I've just been pillaring up with this wood, and, I guess I've been attempting to... cut this tree down. Some things are falling over the I think this is all. I think everything else is just gonna, like, automatically just fall down, like the leaves, as soon as all the wood is gone. They'll just start, despawning. So, I don't know if that's gonna happen right now, because it seems to me as if everything is gone. I'm not sure yet. Anyways. Need to compost up some saplings. You guys won't believe what putting four of them like this equates to. It equates to a lot of profit, that's for sure. The amount of profit I got is intense. We've got our nature chest. I'm gonna call it the nature chest from now on. We got 5 apples. And we got like a stack of or two of wood. Additionally, I do have almost a stack of, yep, 2 stacks of wood, almost. I also have been watering these. And we will get into Agricraft later on in the series, but it's not really a requirement right now, so I don't want to rush into Agricraft because it is a complicated mod. It does require, like, breeding, and then you need to figure out... But eventually, Agricraft can make it so that, like, one potato crop will drop, like, 4 potatoes. One lettuce crop will drop, like, 3 lettuce seeds, so... You have to level up your plants, sort of, if you get what I'm saying. But, in order to do everything, we need to have a cobblestone generator, and that is actually what I'm planning for this episode. We may not get to it, but we will definitely get to it at the start of next episode, so no need to worry. I'm just gonna harvest the rest of these. Okay. Just harvest. Right. I do believe we can craft this into bread. Sweet. Now I believe we can put this in here. Just grab these oak wood planks. I believe we can put this in here and make it into toast. Yes, that's right, guys. Normally, bread replenishes 1.5 hunger. Toast replenishes 2. So, just for cooking up your bread, you're going to get a pretty good surprise. So, eat that now, and you're going to feel pretty well nourished. Okay. Just cooking up these potatoes. Bam. Okay. Looks like the tree has finished breaking down. Or despawning the leaves, rather. Perfect. Everything is going well right now. Ooh. My frying pan. Is that my frying pan? Yeah! Oh, frying pan. I don't really need you anymore, but I mean, hey. Oh yeah, and I forgot to tell you guys, my hatchet got a +1 attack boost. Now it has +7 attack damage, so this is pretty much the ultimate weapon as well now. It's probably the best weapon that I have, at least. And look, all of our dirt's ready to be sieved, so I'm really hoping the first time we get all 4 pieces of cobblestone needed, however that most likely won't be happening. You can get more than 4 per piece of dirt, but that is highly, highly unlikely. Ooh, we did get sugarcane seeds. That's excellent. That's very good. We also did get carrot seeds, and you can get seeds apparently from sieving that. So, we only did get we only got 3 cobblestone, which is just a tad bit unfortunate. Again, I can make another piece of dirt. I do have 4 pieces there. I'm just gonna use this piece of dirt. Just because I'm making a new one anyways. And I believe this should do it. Yes. Sweet. I'm not sure if this is going to be enough, though. And this is actually going to take a long time. So, there are multiple different sources of heat you can use. The first tier is torches. Then the second tier is you put lava underneath it. And then the third tier would be netherrack, and then fire. That does it the fastest, and all three tiers affect how fast it goes. So eventually we'll be able to produce lava at a very, very quick rate. And as a result, we will be able to produce power. Hopefully. Just hopefully. So I'm getting some nice seeds. Another piece of dirt. That's not where I want it to go. So my farm is developing decently. I do actually want to terraform this, however. I don't think this looks too good. I want it to be sort of a flat platform now. These micro parts are just gonna bug me all throughout the series until we move out. Just going to place those right there. I really want speed on this pickaxe. It's kind of slow right now. Nope, that won't work. Just sound like a villager right now. Ooh, that's the void that I don't want to fall into. Okay. I have fixed that. This is right here. That's going to cause OCD. I know it's going to cause it for me. Probably for a lot of other people as well. That's gonna disturb me and annoy me severely. And I'm very glad I fixed that, because now it's coming nighttime and I don't want to be outside when it's nighttime, because bad stuff happens during nighttime. I die during nighttime. Me no like dying. Dying isn't such a good thing in this pack, especially when you have lives. I do want to pillar up there, however. And do something with that. I'm not sure yet. I also do want to build a mob spawning tower pretty soon here, just to start collecting some mob drops. But while I'm waiting for this lava, which is around 1/3 there, most thirds of the way there, I'm gonna look into some other quests. So a fishing rod. We need to make ourselves a fishing rod. Also, we need to catch a fish. Now, this is a quest that I really hate in this pack. It was there in the 1.6.4 version. It's still here in the 1.7.10 version. I don't know why Jaded Cat has not gotten rid of the quest that everyone hates so dearly. But it's here, and we have to deal with it. Yay for fishing! So I'm assuming just cast your line in there. And just... wait... how do you fish? Is this how you fish? How the heck do you fish? Am I doing correctly? Oh, I may have to do this quest off camera, because this is gonna take some time. But the fishing rod is there. It's in my inventory. Flux infused fishing rod. Why would you need that? I believe that fishing rod explodes. Yikes. Okay. Well, I am not going to complete that fishing quest. Never mind, we just need raw fish. And I cannot get a raw fish, because I suck at fishing and... Ugh. The slab furnace. I already made a slab furnace. No, this is terrible. Fishing has got to be the most infuriating part of this quest book, let me tell you. Is there like a fish trap or anything? There's like a net? Something that's gonna get us fish very easily without me having to really try? Oh, that makes me so upset that I actually have to go fish. Okay, whatever. We're not doing that right now. That is going to bore the viewers. I don't want that to happen. We are waiting on our lava. As you can see, it's coming up. Well, we can't really do much without the lava production, so I'm going to come back when I have caught a fish and my lava has completed. Yay! And we're back, guys. So, hallelujah. I finally caught a fish. It didn't really take me too long. However, I did realize that if I extended my pool, it may help, and it did, so very happy that I thought of that. And now I can complete this quest right here. Claim half a heart. Get 16 raw salmon, which then I could use to make into cooked salmon. So I'm actually going to use this to make it into cooked salmon. To get half a heart, which is good. This fish goes here. Okay. Life looks good for us. Next one is flour. Apparently we need flour. How do you make flour? We need wheat with a mortar and pestle. And this is 3 stone. Okay. Luckily, our lava did finish. However, there's one catch. We need to build, we need to make it so that we can move the water first before we move the lava. So, for those of you who remember how to make a cobblestone generator, that's the void. You don't want to remember that. I don't think cobblestone generators in the void are very nice. Okay. Ooh, I got +1 haste. Yes. That's amazing. Right. Don't really know how to do this, to be honest. Maybe right here. I think that right here sounds like a perfectly good idea. So we could have is the water coming in. I could stand here, and the lava could be right here. So just like this. Could position this. Okay, so, actually gonna need to do that, and then get one more block to tidy this up, get a source of water from my unlimited water source. Okay, and that is how you make a cobble gen. Take this lava, put it right here, and we made cobblestone. Now notice that the clay bucket was destroyed in the process. Are you serious? Oh, we need to manual detect. No! To get lava, you need to melt stone. Place the fire crucible over a torch, right click it with cobblestone blocks until it is full. Right click onto the blocks, it is full. Wait until it is melted into lava. Use the clay bucket. There are a lot of typos. Bucket to move the lava to make a cobblestone jet. With some clever positioning, you can use the lava part of your cobblestone to heat the crucible and create more lava. So that actually sounds like a not a bad idea right now. However, I do need a place to harbor it. So, I think right here may be good. Of course we gotta sleep now, right when we get to the good moment, where we have finally made cobble gen. And I can't even sleep in my bed. There we go. Perfect. Now, we are going well. So, I was correct. It is only 4 cobblestone to make a piece of lava or a bucket of lava. So, and notice how quick it goes with the lava. It's actually going to go very, very quickly with the lava. So meanwhile, we can just sit here and keep harvesting this cobblestone. And now, we can actually get started with, you know, progressing within the tech tiers and stuff. But I'm not going to sit here and mine cobblestone all day on screen for you guys. That's just going to be boring. Right. We need to make another clay bucket. Okay. Well, luckily, I believe I have the clay. Okay, sweet. Make myself an unfired clay bucket. Ooh, and make myself some cooked salmon. Now, I'm not... You cannot use cooked salmon for anything, so... Looks like this cooked salmon is going to be our food. Even though... It only gives us 1 hunger, which is very sad. Do to put that in there, just to make some more charcoal. Right. And by the way, 1 bucket of lava will be enough to heat both of these up. Just put the source right there and it'll flow. So, this is slowly melting. Right. On with more quests. So, we're currently doing this one. Oh, I know what we could do. Okay. We need to go along this quest line. So, we need a millstone, which is flour. In order to get flour, we need a mortar and pestle, which is 3 pieces of stone. We are just going to use the newly acquired cobblestone we have got. I'm going to cook that up. Wood goes in there. Right. I'm going to get the stick. And now, make the mortar and pestle. And then we're also going to need a piece of wheat. Good thing we have 1 piece of wheat left. I'm going to prepare this. I believe it was like this, right? Does it matter? Alright, we made the mortar and pestle. Now I combine the mortar and pestle and the wheat to make flour. Yes. This makes me very happy. Now we have flour. Now as a reward, we will get bread and a reward bag. Because the other thing was very insignificant, whatever it was. We did get a basic reward bag, unfortunately. However, it contains shelves. More of a decor, man. More of a decor. Anyways. Now we're cooking. Looks like we already completed this task. Looks like it's gonna give us a bone crook and a reward bag. I would like to take the reward bag just to take my chances. It is another basic reward bag, but we did get 16 pieces of coal, which is a big advancement. This... How is that a crap reward? This is amazing. Oh my gosh, it's amazing. I guess it must be crap for, like, later game, but... Definitely right now, it's not really crap. And I'm gonna cook this all into toast for future use. Okay. Now that we have completed that quest, we have completely completed that quest line. Now we just need the lava, which is currently not done. Why are you not done, lava? Come on. There we go. shouldn't have anything left. I do want to... There we go. I'm going to claim this reward. Put this lava right here. Try to collect this without it burning up. Perfect. And now, as you can see, both of them have a melting speed of 2 times. And we will put this aluminum brass away for future use in a smeltery, which I do believe we will get to next episode. Don't quote me on that. And I just spoiled next episode, didn't I? Crap. Okay. Just genuine greatness. Right. Okay. So, now I have a whole bunch of nether quests we can unlock. We could summon either various dolls. We could find a surprise. We could get into... This will... This doesn't seem too bad, actually. I'm not gonna lie. Or we can go into Endstone. Or we can get to mycelium, which we need ancient spores. Or we could get netherrack. Then we could get blazes. Okay. I'm not sure what I want to do right now. Besides actually show you guys what you actually... Yeah, okay. Before we do anything, I would like to continue on this quest line. That's still cooking. Okay. So we need a trash can. Trash can is from Extra Utilities, and it does what it says. We need 3 pieces of stone. Unfortunately, we do not have enough. 3 pieces of stone and 5 pieces of cobblestone. That shouldn't be too bad. What's that? 5? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Perfect. Additionally, we are also going to need a chest. So... Bam. And bam. Yes. A trash can. This is actually going to be very helpful. I've been waiting for a trash can for quite some time. That is not a good place to put a trash can, is it? What an awful place to put a trash can. Don't really know where to put the trash can, to be honest. Sure, let's just put the trash can right there. Why not? Anyways, we have completed this, and we now get a void bag. We can just void stuff. That's cool, I guess. I mean, I don't really want to void anything right now, but eventually I will. Trust me. Now, we get to automated tedium. The first time for making crafting life less of a drag is the crafting frame. Okay. The super crafting frame. Is it from here? Alright, it's just a crafting table with sticks around it. I actually do want to see what this does. I'm not going to lie. I believe this is it. Perfect. We are actually progressing through these quests very quickly. Mainly because they're beginner quests. To be storing. We need a super item frame and a super void frame. So, this is a dropper with sticks, and this is an enderpearl with sticks. I can do the enderpearl with sticks. However, I don't even know if that's a really good use of my enderpearls, to be honest. Enderpearl. I have to emphasize that I only have 1 enderpearl. And the dropper requires redstone and 7 cobble. Luckily, I did get redstone from killing a witch, I believe. And then 7 pieces of cobblestone should be easy. That just burned. That just burnt too. Stop burning! Oh, that's bad. That is bad, that is bad, that is bad. Okay, right. I don't want that, I don't want that. That is really bad. I have a feeling obsidian just formed under there. What is the... Okay. I need to remedy this immediately. Stop burning! Okay. Now that we have that, we can craft the dropper item frame. What? I just did it the wrong way. I believe we need one more. Perfect. And now we can claim our reward. We get pumpkin pie and 8 iron ingots. That was worth it. And spin the super crafting frame goes on here. What is this? Super item frame. Then super void flame. I mean, I don't really see how these could be useful in any way. Configurable at all? Huh. How do you use these? Barrel or other inventory that has resources you want to craft. Sneak in real quick, open the state the recipe. Now, as long as the inventory has the materials, you can craft the recipe. Okay. That's sort of cool, I guess. So that's good. Oh! We need broken iron ore. Well, guys, I'm going to first sleep and cut camera and see how much time we have left. Be right back, guys. And I'm back, guys. So, we have reached... Oh, okay, that's not good. Yeah, die. Anyways, we have reached like 40 or 45 minutes, guys. It's kind of been a long episode, but before the episode ends, guys, I actually want to show you guys something. So, how you collect resources in this game. Now that you have gravel, sand, and dust, you can save them to get small ore fragments. Combining 4 identical ore fragments will get you a block of that kind. Start by sieving gravel. Basically, how you get resources in this pack is you first have to get gravel, which clearly I'm failing. I definitely need to get this automated. It actually goes straight into your inventory, which is good. Okay. It's just a bit slow. So, what I want to do first is I want to upgrade to a stone hammer, because the speed is unbearable currently. The second thing is, I would like to show you what happens when you sieve gravel. When you sieve gravel, you're going to get stuff like diamonds, emeralds, coal, and you're also going to get the most basic ore clusters. As I'm showing you guys, and sometimes you'll just get nothing, like I'm currently getting. Oh, as you can see, I got a lot of stuff there. I think I got a piece of iron there. I got nothing there. It is a bit inconsistent. However, when you do end up automating it, it can be very good. Okay, so to get broken gold ore, flint, tin, nickel, and iron. I actually want to make a brand new chest just for those items. So, and before the episode ended, I just wanted to show you guys how to do all that. Okay. And I want to place the chest where these need to not be anymore. And all these go right here. And basically, you just keep doing this until you have enough resources. And I just wanted to show you guys this before the episode ended. Unfortunately, I will not be able to finish. Actually, I'm going to finish that quest right now. So, the episode is getting a bit long. However, I really hope that this will cooperate with me. Alright, please just give me some iron so I can complete the quest. So you just gotta keep sieving until you get something. This is actually very inconsistent right now. I don't think it's ever been this inconsistent. I usually get a ton of stuff. But apparently I'm just sieving gravel and not getting anything. Ooh, I do believe I finished the quest. Yes, I did get enough. And I did get coal. Okay. So that's 4 iron. Just gotta manually detect. Crafting task. We are going to now need to craft that into an iron ore gravel. This iron ore gravel can be used directly when put in a smeltery. Hint, hint. Next episode. Hint, hint. This will be melted down, I believe, into 2 ingots. Or you could go the route of hammering this down even more. When you hammer this down even more, you'll get crushed ore sand. No, you'll just get crushed ore. Next, you need to use this to craft that into iron ore sand. Next, you smash this into powdered ore, and then get your dust. Now, the advantages of breaking the gravel down further into dust is that each time you break it down, I believe you have a chance of adding just one dust, so eventually you will get a net gain, just a slight net gain, but nevertheless it's a net gain. So that's the advantage of hammering it down. That was a voice crack. Is you'll just get, like, as you can see, I just got a powdered iron ore, which I can use in a different iron ore breaking down. So That quest is completed. I've got a bunch of progressive automation stuff now to go. And that's what we will be doing next class, baby. Ooh, fishing. That's good. I believe we have everything unlocked. I'm not actually. We don't have power grid and for the hoarding unlocked. But I would like to complete this quest line first. You workshop table. Yes. Okay. Everything's gonna have to be next episode, guys, because unfortunately we are out of time. We are actually way over time. I'm starting to consider making these episodes 45 minutes, just so I don't have to say that. Anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for watching the second episode of our Let's Play Agrarians, guys, too. If you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to hit the like button. And if you guys would like to see more Agrarians, guys, 2 videos, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Anyways, guys, this has been Genuine Greatness, and I hope to see you guys in my next YouTube video. Goodbye!